Hey guys, Leon Chang and Paul Estrada here from CrossFit Elysium, and we're gonna break down workout 15.1, and as it turns out, 15.1A. HQ threw a little wrinkle at us this year, and you actually have two workouts for this week. Both are gonna be completely separately scored and count as their own separate workout. The total duration is gonna be 15 minutes. Workout 15.1 is gonna be 15 toe to bars, 10 deadlifts, and 5 snatch. And the weight for the barbell movement is 115 pounds for men and 75 pounds for women. As many reps as possible in 9 minutes. When that's done, you're gonna immediately roll into workout 15.1A, which is 6 minutes to establish a 1 rep max clean and jerk.
So our first piece of advice for this workout, because it is a little bit longer and there's so much work on the hands and the forearms, we're gonna recommend that you have a strategy going into it and you only do this workout once this week. We don't wanna start off the open with both hands being torn to shreds. As you can see, the 15 toes to bar, that's a lot of footwork, as well as the deadlift and the snatch. It's three entirely different hand positions on barbells or on pull-up bars. So plan on one time this week for this workout.
Paul and I are gonna address our general approach and recommendation for the vast majority of you in a little bit, but we wanted to make special mention in case you're one of those people where one of these workouts is really in your wheelhouse and the other one really is not. So let's give you an example. Say you're someone with a 500 pound clean and jerk, but you can't do a toe to bar. In that case, your strategy is probably gonna be pretty obvious. You should save all your energy for 15.1A and really not be that concerned with 15.1. In fact, you might even want to devote time during 15.1 to warm up for 15.1A properly. Conversely, if 15.1 is really in your wheelhouse, but maybe you have a 1 rep max clean and jerk of 135 pounds, you're probably not gonna do all that well on 15.1A. In that case, give everything you got for 15.1. At the end of those 9 minutes, you should be totally fried. And again, it's probably not gonna matter all that much because we knew you weren't gonna post a good score going into 15.1A anyways. For the vast majority of you, however, that wanna do well in both, we've got some specific points here.
So the first thing we're gonna address is gonna be the toes to bar. It's the highest rep movement in this workout, so that what we're gonna recommend is that you probably want to break these up from the beginning. If you're one of the people that can just do toes to bar all day, maybe break it up into the higher numbers, 10 and 5 or so, to get through a little bit quicker, but for most people, something more like 3 sets of 5 is going to be more realistic in terms of endurance across the 9 minutes, and also going to be a better idea, a better plan for saving the skin on your hands.
The next movement being the deadlift. As Paul alluded to before, the defining feature of this workout is gonna be your grip and how well your grip endurance is gonna hold on, so to speak. So, we recommend a mixed grip. Regardless of your personal preference for this workout, learn the mixed grip and use it. That'll help save your forearms and save your grip for the other movements. The second point with the deadlift, if you have to stop and rest, you might consider stopping at the top and resting before you go into your next rep. That will at least allow you to take advantage of a stretch shortening reflex as you lower the bar for your next rep, which will then help you with that rep. It'll be a little bit easier than breaking the bar off the ground fresh. Lastly, with the deadlift, regardless of who you are, I don't care if this is the lightest deadlift in the world, go nice and steady, pace yourself. Do not go balls to the wall and blow yourself out of the water. You don't want to fry your posterior chain or your explosiveness for the snatch, which Paul is going to talk about now.
So if you're someone where the 115 snatch is relatively light, you're gonna be able to move through it a little bit faster. But for the majority of people, 115 is gonna be somewhere in the medium to heavy range in a Metcon scenario. So for the snatch, we're gonna recommend that you go singles from the beginning. And these aren't singles where at the top you drop and you watch it bounce around half the gym before you go to it. We want you to drop it, stomp it down with your hands or your foot, and make sure it stays by you and you immediately get back on the barbell. But make them very fast singles. Keep your eye on the clock to make sure you're not wasting time. In terms of pacing out the snatch, you're actually gonna wanna pay attention to how you break up the deadlifts, just like Leon was talking about. If you try and sprint through the deadlifts, you're gonna fry your hips and your back, and that's gonna make the snatches even more difficult. If you start missing snatches, it's gonna create a huge mental hard space for you within the workout. So pace it and make sure you don't miss reps, make sure you keep your technique clean.
So from a duration standpoint, we tested this. The ideal round, quote unquote, is gonna take you about a minute to finish. This is with 15 unbroken toe to bars, immediately moving into 10 unbroken deadlifts, followed immediately by 5 very quick snatches. that round took a minute. Clearly that is nothing that you will be able to sustain for the entire 9 minutes, okay? I would be shocked if even Rich Froning could sustain that pace for the entire 9 minutes. So, what we're actually looking at for a performance round, if you're trying to post a pretty good score, is something more in the 120 to 130 per round range. You get that first round in the books, take a look at the clock, make sure you're where you want to be. You should not be moving faster than 120, 125 for that round, because you will for sure blow yourself out of the water for the rest of the workout. And you can use that to kind of gauge where you're at. If you're someone who can hold 120, 125 for the whole 9 minutes, great, more power to you. Our personal prediction here is we're gonna see a top scorer around the world, 7-ish, maybe 8 rounds.
So now we're gonna talk about moving into 15.1A. Again, most of you aren't gonna be all out sprinting through that 9 minutes. You're gonna need to pace that out so that way you finish and you still have everything about you. You're not on the ground about to die. When you get to 15.1A, you should have already been warmed up. Before you started the Metcon, you probably wanted to warm up to somewhere around 75 to 80% of whatever your best max is at the moment. That's gonna help you warm up the specific movement, but also help you warm up your posterior chain, your legs, and everything for the deadlift and the snatches within 15.1. When you start 15.1A, make sure you have your plates and all your weights that you think you're gonna be using in your area. Don't have them haphazardly spread around, but have the weights in order to go on your barbell as quickly as possible. Get a nice conservative number in the books to make sure that you have a score. And once you have that conservative number, probably in the 70-75% range, then you can bump it up to the higher 80-85-90, or even going for a PR if you're feeling good. But make sure you get the conservative number in the books and then pace out your attempts. You're probably only going to get somewhere in the neighborhood of 3 to 4 quality attempts in that 6 minutes. Remember, the second part is not a Metcon, it's a strength event. So you need to pay attention to the clock accordingly.
So now we're gonna show you some demonstrations involving the Tota Bar, kind of what we would recommend as far as how to move your body and some common movement faults. Good luck, guys. This is gonna be an interesting one.
So here we're giving you a little bit of an example of the toes to bar. You wanna remember that as you're doing them, to stay nice and tight, keep the legs together, and make them nice and efficient. As soon as you start deteriorating and getting wild and crazy, you can see the hands get a lot of extra work, so you're better off just dropping off the bar and keeping them clean. For the deadlifts, make sure that if you rest, you're gonna rest at the top. All you wanna do is pull your shoulders back a little bit extra, get some weight off the wrist and the back, rest there, and then continue to tap the ground and keep moving on those deadlifts. For the snatches, make sure that once you drop it, you stay close to your bar, make sure the barbell doesn't bounce away from you, and pull it right back into position. Don't let the barbell bounce to the side and cause you extra time to have to chase it around the floor.